There's a very beautiful yet extremely simple mantra of the Devi. I want all of us to chant this mantra together to invoke the Devi, because we can't enter into any process without her grace. So before we chant the mantra together, I would like to say a few things on the mantra so that we all understand the profundity of this simple mantra. So as every mantra begins with the chant of Om, so it says, Om Sarva Mangala Mangalya. I'll repeat this line before moving forward. So the salutation, Om, and salutation to the one, Sarva Mangala Mangalya. Salutation to the one whose auspiciousness in all that is auspicious. Meditate on this. Salutations to the one whose auspiciousness in all that is auspicious. Shive Sarvartha Sadhike. To the consort of Shiva. Sarvartha Sadhike has a very beautiful meaning. Means in a simple way it would mean the one who is accomplisher of all the objectives, all the pursuit. But there's another deeper meaning of that also. That salutation to the mother, Sarvartha Sadhike, who makes sure that all the four stages of human pursuits are being achieved. What are the four stages of human pursuit? The dharma is the first stage of human pursuit. The earth, which is the material wealth, is the second pursuit. The kama, which is the enjoyment, the sense pleasure of all that we can experience through the senses. And moksha, the final liberation from the cyclic movement of life and death. So all these four key pursuits of human existence, the mantra says, we salute to that, we invoke that Devi who makes sure that all these four objectives are also accomplished. Profound. That's the second one. In the third sutra, the mantra says, Sharanya Trayambake Gauri. Sharanya means the one who is the source of all the refuge. Trayambake means the three-eyed ones. That's a literal meaning. But that also means the one who's the mother of all the three worlds. You know, we say that in the Indian tradition we use this word a lot, Tina Loka, the three worlds. The first word is the Bhumi, the plane of existence of earth, the first loka. The second loka is the antariksh, the space, the loka of the space, the plane of existence of the space. And the third loka is of the heavens. So you have earth as first realm of existence, then you have heaven as the third realm of existence, and you have the space as the second realm of existence. So the mantra says, the one who is the Lord, who is the owner, who is the mother of all the three worlds of existence. This can also, Trayambake can also be translated into the one who governs all the three energies. What are the three energies? The Rajas, the energy of activity. The Sattva, the energy of absolute balance. And tamas, the energy of inertia. So the mother, we are invoking the mother who is also the Lord, also the mother of the three energies. She governs all these three energies. Can also be interpreted, Trayambake can also be interpreted as the mother who governs all the three phases of time as we experience in human realm. What are the three phases of time? The past is phase one, the present is phase two, and the future is phase three. So the mother who also governs all the three phases of time as we experience as human beings, Trayambake. Sanskrit is a beautiful language. Each word has multiple connotations. when used in a different perspective, the meaning of the word changes. So Triambake can be explained into these multiple ways. Gauri, the literal meaning of the word Gauri, Sharanya Triambake Gauri. The literal meaning of the word Gauri is the fair-skinned one. One would wonder why would they say, why would they make this distinction between fair skin and not fair skin? Well, that's not what the meaning of the word hair. Here the word Gauri means the one who emanates light, one whose entire body is the body of light, that mother we are invoking. The last line says, Narayani namastute namastute. Narayani, who is the, again, it, in a different way of saying, Narayani, who is the better half, Narayani is the better half of Narayana, and Narayana is the Lord of the world. So in different words, we are saying the same things through this mantra. And then namastute means we bow down. So we bow down to this Devi, to this mother. That's the meaning of this beautiful chant.